Hi there, this is Vaseem Asgar. I'm a licensed professional engineer in US and Canada. I'm the author of several books on the topic of FE Electrical and Computer Exam and PE Power Exam Preparation. I've also developed FE Electrical and Computer Exam Preparation online programs as well as for PE Power Exam. And in this video, I'm going to answer the question, which FE exam should you take? If you're a relatively recent grad and have heard about EIT certificate, or if it has been on your to-do list for a lot of time and you've been out of school for a long time, you know that there's several options for you when it comes to the FE exam. And I'll tell you my recommendation up front. I suggest that you take the FE exam that is within your discipline. For example, if you're a mechanical engineer, I recommend that you go for FE mechanical. If you're a civil engineer, you should go for FE civil. If you're an electrical or a computer or a software or instrumentation, electronics, telecommunication, or a computer engineer, you should go for FE electrical and computer. Now, what are the other alternatives? If you're a chemical engineer, you can potentially also go for FE environmental or other disciplines. If you're a mechanical engineer, in addition to FE mechanical, you can potentially also go for FE industrial or other disciplines. A controls engineer may consider doing FE chemical or FE other discipline. But my general recommendation is to stay within your discipline. And there's one simple reason for that. If you're an electrical engineer and you go for FE other disciplines, there are two challenges that you'll have to overcome. One in the short term and the other one in the long term. In the short term, you'll have to learn a little bit of content which is not core electrical or computer. Some content from chemical, some content from mechanical. Students typically have this perception that since FE other discipline is sort of a mishmash of a lot of different disciplines, that the level of difficulty is going to be a little bit lower. But the fact of the matter is that even if arguably that level of difficulty is lower, I don't know if it is lower or not, but even if it is lower, you are actually being made to learn new concepts. And that leads me to my second reason, which is sort of medium to long-term issue with it, which is the fact that if you do FE other disciplines, let's take the example of an electrical engineer. If an electrical engineer does FE other disciplines, when they get to prepare for the PE exam, little to nothing that they learn from FE other disciplines is gonna carry over to the PE exam. That basically means that the new concepts that you learn specifically for FE other disciplines have not really helped you move the needle a tiny bit. Now compare and contrast this to a computer engineer who stayed with FE electrical and computer, an instrumentation engineer who decided to stick with FE electrical and computer, a software engineer who went for FE electrical and computer. Now when this individual goes on to prepare for the PE exam, regardless of which option they take in the PE exam, whether that is PE power, which by far is the most popular option amongst the electrical engineers, or PE electronics communications, at least 10, 15, 20, 25, maybe up to 30% of what they studied in FE electrical will carry over to PE power. And when you're starting from a foundation that has already been laid, the journey for the PE exam preparation becomes a lot more easier. Now, it doesn't mean that if you've taken FE other discipline, then you're going to struggle immensely in the next stage, which is a PE exam. It just means that the synergy is sort of reduced. And I understand that some students have a very diverse undergraduate background. If you want to continue as a generalist, there are options out there and FE other disciplines might be suitable. But in 9 out of 10, maybe 95% of the cases, I recommend students to stick with their disciplines because it is going to help you in the short term as well as the long term. And if you want to learn more about preparation of FE electrical and computer exam and the PE power exam, then check out these playlists over here. Thanks for watching and I'll see you soon in the next video.